let's go for that mutton chops. Big chunks of meat. Get some of that gravy on it. You know, the meat here is a sort that has a bit of a bite. None of the other dishes I found spicy in terms of the heat quotient, but this particular preparation here, can definitely feel the singeing heat on my tongue and also at the back of my head where I've begun to now sweat. Oh, idrali meat bahala soft ide. Oh, this meat is a sort that will melt like tuppa. Tuppa tara karige hogute idu. Hi folks, this is Kripal Amana, Gourmet on the Road, and you're watching Food Lovers TV. I hope you're doing well. We are in Mysuru, in the heart of Mysuru actually. We just passed the palace and all the splendid sights that you take in this city. And today we've set out to lunch at an eatery, though modest in its look, is an eatery that's been around for the last three and a half decades. We're going to a place called Lakshman Mess, and Lakshman Mess serves authentic Mysuru style Nati Uta. Let's go. Namaskara. So this is Satya, Lakshman's son, owner of Lakshman Mess, and it's interesting to learn of the journey that this eatery has made. It began as a pushcart at that location where we parked our car. It then moved to a tiny establishment here, and then they had their home here, which they broke down and they converted into this eatery. So let's go in and see what Lakshman Mess is all about. Oh, that's the cart, that pushcart there.
Yes, sir.
So how many years did you run that pushcart?
Around 20 years.
20 years, yes. From 1989. So that's fascinating. That's the beginning of Lakshman Mess.
Yes.
That's your kitchen?
Yes, sir.
Can I take a look?
Yes, sir. Actually, this is mutton chops.
Mutton chops?
Yeah.
The weight is there?
Sir,
it's
dum marte na.
Mutton chops are dum marte
na? Yes, sir.
Oh, that's interesting. So you put some bay leaf?
Before giving the dum.
Before giving the dum. And how long do you keep on dum?
It takes around 1 hour.
1 hour. So it has been on for 1 hour now?
Yes, sir. That's so why fat is kept 1 hour.
That's
you can
right.
See the fat right.
So the fat has emerged from the meat.
Meat, sir.
So they basically cook the meat for about 45 minutes.
70-75%.
Then you put some bay leaves on top.
Yes, sir.
Close it, put some weight on top, and let it cook in that steam. So I think right now in this mutton chops, all the flavor of the meat is concentrated.
Yes, this is the main ingredient. 20-25 years old masala.
This is aromatic.
Huh? My mom and dad invented kind of an invention.
Oh, nice. There's a lot of cinnamon in this.
Yes, sir. Huh? Cinnamon, elaichi.
Elaichi, cardamom. I can smell those two very prominently.
Bay leaf also. And jaikai.
Some nutmeg. Okay. And then javitri also, the mace.
Yes, sir. Mace also.
Do you also put some marat mogu in this?
Definitely, sir. All the spices.
Kalua, stone flour.
Adding all the spices won't make this perfection. The quantity makes the perfection.
The proportions.
Proportion, quantity.
And that is a formula that is how
formula.
Old?
Dad and my mom.
35 years ago.
35 years ago.
This spice blend is absolutely alluring in its aroma. I can smell the cinnamon, I can smell a bit of the cardamom,
yes.
A bit of the nutmeg. You know, this is the sort of spice blend on a lighter note. You can sprinkle some of it on your pillow and go to bed. You'll have delicious dreams and wake up with a hearty appetite. That's the sort of aromatic spice blend this is.
Red chili powder, it will directly come from Byadgi.
From Byadgi
itself. Usually, the Guntur red chili powder will make food very spicy. Our hotel is kind of a hotel where the food will not be more spicy or less spicy. It's kind of a medium thing.
And that's how the Byadgi helps.
Yeah, that's right.
Look at that bright orangish red color of that chili.
And pepper powder.
Pepper powder.
We will grind it separately.
You grind the pepper yourself.
Yeah.
So now what's happening? The finishing.
Yes, sir.
So this, what I'm seeing is only the meat juice right now.
Yes, sir.
Meat juice, the onions, the masala, turmeric.
Turmeric.
Coriander powder.
Coriander powder.
Do you also put some coriander in this? Coriander and mint?
Yes, sir, coriander.
Mint, did you put pudina?
Yes, sir. What do you call
ogarne? Ogarne, right in the beginning you put that.
It will make the chops come bit greenery.
Bit green, that's right. So that's the color that comes from the coriander and the mint. So is this your most signature dish?
Actually, our customer usually prefer to have boti.
To boti. I saw boti is on many plates there.
Yeah, yeah.
This sheep, is goat or sheep?
Sheep, sir.
Sheep, kuri.
Kuri, tagaro.
Huh?
Tagaro.
Ah, so this is the horned sheep.
Yeah.
So is that male or female?
Male. In case of female, it won't taste better like the male one. Male one tastes better.
The male goat is sitting around, lazy fellow. Whereas the female goat is the more industrious one, rearing, giving birth to baby lambs or kid lambs every year. The male fellow is sleeping, sitting around, lazy, therefore his meat is tender. And that's why he meets his fate in this pot, the taguru lamb.
Taguru.
Ah, the male lamb.
The mixture of pepper and coconut paste.
So you grind the coconut fine to a paste with the pepper and then you add some water.
Yes.
So this is the coconut pepper paste. Is it H2 meat there, Satya?
Almost 14 kilos.
14 kilo.
Yeah.
Normal weekday only just
here. Yeah, that's
not. H2
20-25 kilos.
For the one time. For one
time. This is for one time.
How many times do you make?
Morning, afternoon and evening.
Morning, afternoon, evening. Okay. Ideally. I like the way he's scraping all that masala from the side. You know, because as the meat cooks, that vapor rises and some of it sticks to the side of that vessel with all the flavors of the meat. Satya here is scraping it, making sure he is adding it back to that meat curry, that meat korma. What do you call this dish?
Mutton chop.
Mutton chops.
Idhar chikki ide, nalli mule ide.
Nalli mule ide.
Idhar chikki ide. Ella tara teeskolide, line teeskolide.
So when they say chops here, it's basically meat without the organ meat, without the liver, kidney and things like that. But it's basically all meat of the male sheep goes into this. I can see that curry bubbling away. So basically you have all the flavor of the meat that's now mingling with that peppered coconut milk and that chops is now bubbling away. Ready?
Yeah.
I can taste?
Yes.
You know me, I will never say no to a tasting straight off the vessel as that dish is being cooked. So it's ready?
Ready, sir.
Well, Satya takes a look and he knows it's ready. So it tells you that they really know their food here. Oh, busy, busy there though. Ah, that meat is pink. I've got a spoon to help me better. You know, the more I'm struggling, the more I want to eat this. As soon as I can. So there's a certain creaminess to that curry and you can taste the flavor of that pepper. And the meat is tender yet has some bite. That's delicious. And the curry, you can also taste the flavor of some of the fenugreek.
Yes.
You know, some of the green flavors of coriander. Is the roti again tintare?
Mutton palav, chicken palav. Good day.
That's certainly the dish that you should order when you're here at Lakshman Mess. This is the mutton palav.
Yes, sir.
Nice. I love the aromas. I think food is so much about aromas. Taking in the aroma of the spice mix and now that aroma of that pulao as it's being stirred here by Satya. You can see pink meat, you can also see a bit of the fat. So what is special about your pulao? What goes into it?
If meat is good, pulao will be definitely going to be good.
Some pulao as well to taste. And the rice is a combination of kolam and basmati.
Basmati.
Lakshman Mess pulao. Oh, idrali meat bala soft ide. Oh, this meat is a sort that will melt like tuppa. Tuppa tara karige hogata idu. There's a bit of fat that's trapped in between the meat and that gives it a lush melt in the mouth sort of texture. That's the sort of meat you can eat. No teeth even you can eat. This pulao is very mellow in its flavor, no? It's very mild. And I think if I would personally eat this pulao, relish its delicate flavors by itself and also maybe combine it with some of your chop. Yes. Is that what your customers do?
Yeah, usually if someone wants to eat the palav in the regular taste, they will go like this.
Huh.
If someone wants more spice, they will add some chops like that.
Very delicate.
Very mild. That's what I told before. Not totally spicy, not too...
You can definitely detect the fresh flavors, whether it's the coriander. I think even the chili is very little, not too much.
Not much. Very little.
Oh, that's a gentle pulao. So every day, whatever ghee you're using, you'll put a bit of betel leaf.
Yes, sir. On the morning, we used to put the betel leaves in just before boiling this.
And then you heat the ghee.
Yeah.
And how much betel leaf you put?
2 or 3 leaves. It's just not totally all the leaves need to go inside.
That's interesting. Although you can't really detect it, but he says that they put some betel leaf wedges, about 2 or 3 leaves in the batch of ghee that's used for the day. Yes. In how many liters, how many kilos of ghee?
1 or 2 kilos.
In about a couple of kilos of ghee, they add the edges of the betel leaf, and he says that prevents batch of ghee from turning rancid.
Yeah, yeah.
And that's a ritual every morning. So what is here?
Chicken chops.
Chicken chops. So again, it's like a chicken curry.
Yeah.
So a similar masala as the...
The coconut will not be added to this.
No coconut in this?
No coconut.
So it's onion based mostly?
No, onion. Totally
onions. Onions and greens?
Onion, greens.
Coriander,
main.
Tomato?
Tomato. Okay. This is chicken korma.
Chicken korma. So this has a lot of red chili powder.
Yeah.
Ragi ball, the ragi mudde. Fantastic. After taking in all the food, I think it's time to find a table and savor the Lakshman mess experience. Namaskara, sir. ನಾನು ಭಾಳ ಕೇಳಿದ್ದೇನೆ ಲಕ್ಷ್ಮಣ್ ಮೆಸ್ ಬಗ್ಗೆ.
ಫಸ್ಟ್ ನಮ್ಮ ತಾಯಿ ಮಾಡೋರು, ಆಮೇಲೆ ಮಿಸ್ಸಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಿದ್ರು, ನಾನು ಮಾಡ್ತಿದ್ದೆ ಅಡುಗೆ. ನಮ್ಮ ಮಗ ಅವ್ರು ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. ಎಲ್ಲ ಬಿಟ್ಟರೆ ಇಲ್ಲ ನಮ್ಮ ಹೋಟ್ಲಲ್ಲಿ 35-40 ವರ್ಷದಿಂದ ನಾವೇ ಪ್ರಿಪೇರ್ ಮಾಡೋದು, ಅಡುಗೆ ಮಾಡೋದು, ಮಸಾಲೆ ಹಾಕೋದೆಲ್ಲ ನಾನು ನನ್ನ ಮಗ ನಾವೇ.
ಸೊ ನೀವು ಇದು ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡುವಾಗ ನಿಮಗೆ ನಿಮ್ಮದು ಏಜ್ ಎಷ್ಟಿತ್ತು ಅವಾಗ? 20. ಸೊ ಹೇಗೆ ನಿಮಗೆ ಐಡಿಯಾ ಬಂತು ಊಟದ ಬಗ್ಗೆ?
ಇಲ್ಲ, ನಮ್ಮ ಅಮ್ಮಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿತ್ತು ಅದು. ನಮ್ಮ ಅಮ್ಮ ಮಾಡ್ತಿದ್ರು, ತಾಯಿ ಮಾಡೋರು. ಮನೇಲಿ ಮಾಡೋದನ್ನ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು, ಒಣ ಮಸಾಲೆ ಫಸಲ್ ಪಲಾವ್ ಮಾಡೋರು. ಆಮೇಲೆ ಚೇಂಜ್ ಮಾಡಿ ನಾನು ಆರ್ಡರ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಒಂದೊಂದೊಂದೊಂದೊಂದು ಐಟಮ್ಗಳು ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು. ಮುಂದೆ ಅವಾಗೆಲ್ಲ ಎಷ್ಟು 6 ರೂಪಾಯಿ 7 ರೂಪಾಯಿ ಬಿರಿಯಾನಿ. ಅವಾಗ
6 ರೂಪಾಯಿ ಬಿರಿಯಾನಿ ಯಾವಾಗ? 1990.
ಹಾಗಿದೆ. ಗಾಡಿ ಪೆಟ್ರೋಲ್ ಪಕ್ಕ ನಿಲ್ಲಿಸ್ತೀನಿ.
ಸೊ ಯಾಕೆ ಇಷ್ಟಪಡ್ತಾರೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಮೈಸೂರು? ಎಲ್ಲರೂ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ
ಲೋಕಲ್ ಗಿರಾಕಿನೇ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಇರ್ಬೋದು.
ಯಾಕೆ ಇಷ್ಟು ಪಡ್ತಾರೆ? ಅಷ್ಟು
ಆರಾಗ್ನೇ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಮನೇಲಿ ಊಟ ಮಾಡ್ದಂಗೆ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ನಮ್ಮ ಮಗು ನಮ್ಮ ಮೊಮ್ಮಕ್ಕಳು ಏನು ಊಟ ಮಾಡ್ತವೆ ಅದೇ ಗಿರಾಕಿ ಕೊಡಬೇಕು ಅನ್ನೋ ನಮ್ಮ ಭಾವನೆ. ನಮ್ಮದು ನಾನು ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ದಿನ ಪಂಸಾರಿ ಅಂಗಡಿಯಲ್ಲಿದ್ದೆ. ಚಕ್ಕೆ ಲವಂಗ ಮಸಾಲೆ ಐಟಮ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ನನಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿರುತ್ತೆ, ಕ್ವಾಲಿಟಿಗಳು ಗೊತ್ತಿರುತ್ತೆ ನಿಮಗೆ. ಚಕ್ಕೆಲೆ 4 ಥರ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಲವಂಗ 5-6 ಥರ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಏಲಕ್ಕಿ ಗ್ರೀನ್ ಏಲಕ್ಕಿ, ವೈಟ್ ಏಲಕ್ಕಿ. ಏಲಕ್ಕಿ ಅಂತ ಹಾಕ್ಬಿಡ್ತಾರೆ, ಅದೆಲ್ಲ ಗ್ರೀನ್ ಅಥವಾ ವೈಟು ಅನ್ನೋದು ಇರುತ್ತೆ.
ಸೊ ಯಾವುದು ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿರುತ್ತೆ?
ಗ್ರೀನ್.
ಗ್ರೀನ್
ಅದೇನು ವೈಟಾಗಿ ಕಾಣಲ್ಲ, ಕ್ಲೀನಾಗಿ ಕಾಣಲ್ಲ. ಅದು ಒಳಗಡೆ ಆಯಿಲ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಅದು ಚಕ್ಕೆನೂ ಅಷ್ಟೇ, ಅಮ್ಕಿದ್ರೆ ಆಯಿಲ್ ಬರುತ್ತೆ ಅದು.
So he says that before he began his pushcart, he's worked in a spice shop for some time, and therefore he also knows how to select his spices. To select the right cardamom, the right cinnamon, and spices, after all, I think non-vegetarian food only spices bada important.
Spices irbeku adralli ಹಾಕಲ್ಲ ಮಸಾಲೆ ನೀವು ಇಷ್ಟಕ್ಕೆ ಆದರೂ ಬರಲ್ಲ, ಇಷ್ಟೇ ಆಗಲಿ ಅವೇನು ಸೆಲೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಅದ್ರ ಏನು ಇರುತ್ತೆ
ಕಾಂಬಿನೇಷನ್.
ಮೆಣಸಿನವರೆಗೂ ನಾವೇ ಬಿಡಿಸಿದ್ದು, ಯಾವುದು ರೆಡಿ ತಂದು ಹಾಕಲ್ಲ ನಾವು, ಪೆಪ್ಪರ್ ಪೌಡರ್ ನಾನೇ ಬಿಡಿಸೋದು. ನಾನು
He says the food that he serves here is very home style, and after all, this was his earlier home that he demolished to construct this three-storied Lakshman mess. That indeed is a fascinating journey from a pushcart 35 years ago that he operated for 20 years to this three-storied eatery. That indeed is an inspiring story. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you. ಅವರು ಏನು ತಿಂತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ? ಅದು ಬ್ರೌನ್
ಮಟನ್ ಫ್ರೈ.
ಮಟನ್ ಫ್ರೈ? ಹಾಂ, ಐ ಡೆಂಟ್ ಸಿ ಇಟ್ ಡೌನ್. ಒಂದು ಬಟನ್ ಫ್ರೈ ಕೊಡಿ ನನಗೆ, ಒಂದು ಬೊಟ್ಟಿ ಗೊಜ್ಜು ಕೊಡಿ, ಆಮೇಲೆ ಒಂದು ಚಾಪ್ಸ್ ಕೊಡಿ, ಮಟನ್ ಪಲಾವ್ ಕೊಡಿ, ಚಿಕನ್ ಕಬಾಬ್ ಕೊಡಿ ಒಂದು. ಟು ಆರ್ ಬ್ಯಾಡ್ ಲಕ್, ದಿ ಬೋಟಿ ಈಸ್ ಓವರ್ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ. ದೇ ಆರ್ ಪ್ರಿಪೇರಿಂಗ್ ಅ ಫ್ರೆಶ್ ಬ್ಯಾಚ್, ಬಟ್ ದೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಮೇನ್ ಪರ್ಹ್ಯಾಪ್ಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಬಿ ರೆಡಿ ಬಿಫೋರ್ ವಿ ಲೀವ್, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಐ ಡೋಂಟ್ ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ರಶ್ ದ ಕುಕಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ರಾಸೆಸ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆ್ಯಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಐ ಆಮ್ ನಾಟ್ ಸರ್ಪ್ರೈಸ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಎಸ್ ಐ ವಾಕ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ದ ರೆಸ್ಟೋರೆಂಟ್, ಐ ಸಾ ಎವ್ರಿ ಟೇಬಲ್ add a portion of the boti goju. And I guess when it comes to boti, you only make those many portions, but they have finished. I of course have katoris of the chicken gravy, the mutton gravy, there's a chutney here. But what we are here for is some of this. So this is the mutton palau, which is a popular dish here. Look around, you will find at least a couple of plates of palau on the tables. And then this is the trio of mutton dishes here. This of course is the chops that we saw being finished with that peppered coconut milk. This is the khaima unde. This is the mutton fry. This is an inspired creation, not your typical naati preparation. This has some soy sauce in it. And of course you have the mandatory fried curry leaves. And this is the solitary chicken dish that we have here on the table today, a chicken fry. I think we'll make a beginning with that chicken fry, because I think once we taste the other dishes, this chicken will have a tough act to follow. This chicken on the bone, there's a bit of cartilage that I bit into. It's a mild flavored masala on the outside, but on the inside, I feel that the chicken could perhaps do with a little more seasoning. Let's give it another shot. Busy, busy there. It's steaming hot, as you can see. I'm enjoying it with the curry leaf, because that curry leaf gives it a bit of a flavor boost, and this chicken needs that on the inside especially. I've been given to understand that the mutton dishes here are more popular, and from my experience with the solitary chicken dish here, I would certainly agree with that. The batter though has a nice crunch. Let's go for that mutton chops. Big chunks of meat, get some of that gravy on it. You know, the meat here is a sort that has a bit of a bite. As I learned from Satya down there, he says we don't want our meat to be mushy, we want our meat to assert itself on the bite. When people are eating the mutton here, they should feel like that they're eating mutton. So it's not really chewy, but it certainly has a bit of a bite, and especially some of these pieces which have a bit of fat that's ribboned through the meat. What I love is the flavor of that masala. So you've got the freshness of the greens, a fair bit of coriander, some mint that goes into it, along with some onions, there's a bit of tomato that goes in. And then of course that very aromatic spice blend that we saw with 25 spices. And then the meat cooks. The meat cooks, and then they cook that meat on dum, allowing for all the spices to seep into the meat. And then finally the lid is removed, and in goes the peppered coconut milk, just to soften the flavors, just to soften the sharp edge of that masala. And I think that coconut milk also makes that mutton gravy a worthy companion to a rice dish or a ragi mudde, if that's what you fancy. I think next, before I move to the mutton fry or the khaima unde, I'm going to go for that palau, because this palau I think is mild in its flavors. There are about 4 pieces of meat that you get in every portion of the palau. So there's plenty of meat to accompany every grain of that basmati and kolam rice combination that's used. Let's go for the rice first. So the rice here is a blend of the short grain kolam and the long grain basmati. The basmati gives it more of the aroma. The kolam, on the other hand, is quite shy on the olfactory senses. That's a biryani that is moist. They call this a palau here. My apologies. The rice in this is moist. You place this in your mouth and there is enough juice or enough moistness in that rice. You got the faint edge of the green chili. There's plenty of the flavors of the green masala, whether it's the coriander or the mint that you taste here. And even the spice mix that goes into this is quite muted in the manner in which it asserts itself over the rice. I think time now to taste some of the meat. In contrast to the meat with a bit of a bite in the mutton chops, in the palau, the meat is soft, meltingly tender. That's delicious. And the meat has absorbed some of the spice, but it still dominates in its meaty flavors. And the gelatinous texture of the fat that's ribboned through this meat. Well, the place is certainly getting busy. When we came up to the first floor, there were not too many customers here, but now every table has been taken. It tells you of the popularity of Lakshman Mess. This is a very gentle palau. In fact, you have to look hard for the spices in this pulao. You're mostly tasting the flavor of the fresh ingredients that go in, and the spice mix is there in the gentlest of warmth that it lends to this pulao. So if you like it spicy, that's where these gravies come in handy. This, for instance, is a mutton curry. And of course, when you combine the pulao with this gravy, then it's a different story altogether. Then you have the full-on flavor of that masala. Then there's very little scope for some of the ingredients of the pulao, like this star anise, to actually register. You know, I find the mild flavors of this pulao quite surprising. Because when you come to a naughty sort of a place, an establishment which serves food that's much loved by the locals, and I know this pulao is much loved by people here, it's interesting to note that this is very, very, very mild in its flavors. But the fact is, the locals love this, and they may not eat it just by itself, but with plenty of the gravies to go along, or some of the other side dishes, whether it's the mutton chops or the khaima unde that I will go for next, or that mutton fry. So they're basically borrowing from the spice quotient, from the heat quotient of these gravies to liven up that pulao. But if you ask me, when you're here, taste the pulao just by itself. If you feel you need a little extra, then certainly add the gravies that you will find in the other preparations. And now after tasting that masala, I can barely register the pulao on my palate. The meatiness of the meat though, with some of the fat that's ribboned through it, you won't miss its impact on your taste buds. Okay, let's go for some of that khaima unde. Plenty of ginger and garlic that I can see in that. You're tasting the meat and perhaps also some flour, some chickpea flour or something like that, that goes in to bring it together. There's also coriander, the pungency of the garlic and the heat of the green chili that you can definitely taste. And I'm sure there's plenty of red chili powder too that's gone into this. And this is a dish that I find spicy. None of the other dishes I found spicy in terms of the heat quotient, but this particular preparation here, I can definitely feel a singeing heat on my tongue and also at the back of my head where I've begun to now sweat. Let's taste some of that mutton fry. This is an interesting dish, but not something that fits into the flavor profile of the other dishes that I've tasted here until now. See where that deep umami flavors of that soy sauce. There's a bit of sweetness. I don't know if there's some ketchup that goes into this, but it's not really a dish that I expect to taste at a place like Lakshman Mess. Out here, I'm happier with the chops, with the khaima unde, and of course that pulao. And I'm going to go back to that pulao now, just to get my palate back into the Lakshman Mess swing of things. I think we'll go for some more of the chops. You know, once you go to tasting some of those gravies with the pulao, then you're forced to go back to those gravies because the pulao otherwise doesn't register. So before you mix the pulao with the other gravies, ensure that you relish it by itself. Also make sure that you eat your pulao really hot, because the meat is the sort that has a fair bit of fat. There's also some ghee that goes in to season the spices when they begin making the pulao. So as that pulao cools down, it also tends to solidify a bit. So you want to eat that pulao when it's hot, when all that fat is still in its molten form. So all in all, a happy experience here at Lakshman Mess. I'm definitely returning for that mutton pulao, that very delicate, very shy flavored mutton pulao. I love it. And if you'd like to spice it up, definitely that mutton chops. The one dish that I missed today was that boti goju, and that's a dish that I'm also going to return for. The khaima unde is nice if you like something fiery, like something spicy. But from the dishes that I've tasted here, I think it's truly the mutton that rules the menu here at Lakshman Mess. I hope you enjoyed this episode as much as I enjoyed some of the dishes here. And until the next time, take care, stay safe, and happy eating. If you'd like to support the work that we do at Food Lovers TV, do consider joining our membership community on YouTube by hitting the join button below or on the homepage. You could pledge a nominal sum and receive special privileges like behind the scenes footage, shoot updates, access to live Q&As, and a lot more. You could support us on a Patreon page as well. For more info, check out the links in the description below. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe, like, share, and leave a comment below. Happy eating!